Assalamu alaikum, dear students. I am Dr. Shahana. We are studying the breast cancer, and in this lecture, we will cover the breast cancer of the locally advanced stage 3 breast cancer. In case of the advanced breast cancer, the cancer is spreaded into the axillary lymph node. जो भी surrounding में lymph node है, उसमें involvement हो चुकी है cancer की. Cure rate is less. The treatment strategy is same, that is, first of all, we will go for the new adjuvant or primary chemotherapy. It is basically the initial treatment of choice. And initially, we will go for the chemotherapy rather than the surgery and radiation. What are the advantages of starting the initial chemotherapeutic regimens before the surgery is that this type of the strategy will capable a person that undergoing the surgery कि जो cancer है अब वो पहले जो surgery से remove नहीं हो सकता था. Now this cancer is now operable and resectable. अब वो cancer जो है वो जो spreaded cancer था उसका size shrink हो जाएगा और वो फिर stage 1 stage 2 तक चला जाएगा, जिसकी वजह से then we will go for the strategy of the stage 1 and stage 2. Initially, we will start with the chemotherapy. The drug of choice or the primary chemotherapy is the anthracycline and the taxane containing regimen. Along with the use of the trastuzumab in the hormone receptor positive tumors. After the chemotherapy, there will be the surgery and there will be the radiation therapy as per the need of a person. And the cure is the primary goal of the therapy. Same chemotherapeutic regimens that we have discussed, or those regimens that are designed for the metastatic cancers will be considered for the management of the stage 3 type of breast cancer. Then we have the last stage of the breast cancer, that is the metastatic breast cancer. The metastasis is prevalent to the distinct organ like bone, like lungs, and for that the choice of the therapy for the metastatic breast cancer is based on the site where the disease is spreaded. The management of the metastatic breast cancer involves initial use of the endocrine therapy, then subsequent use of the chemotherapy along with the other biological or targeted therapy. And if there is a possibility, then there will be the radiation therapy who destroy the secondary metastasis of the bone or any other distant organ. There will be no surgery as the disease is very much spreaded. Now the question arises in our mind that which endocrine therapy is beneficial or superior to the another on the basis of the survival benefit. The choice of the agent is not clear. It is basically based on the clinical trials. Furthermore, it is also based on its mechanism of action along with the toxicity and the patient preference. Endocrine therapy is the first choice, especially for those tumors or cancer which are hormone receptor positive, that are present either in a soft tissue, that are present in a bone, pleura, or any other visceral organs. In this case, patients are sequentially treated with the endocrine therapy until and unless will regress, the tumor will regress, and at that time then after the endocrine therapy, chemotherapy should be started. For endocrine therapy, the main purpose, as these are the hormone receptor sensitive tumors or cancers, and aromatase inhibitors are the drug of choice or first line therapy for the postmenopausal women. Aromatase inhibitors are those drugs that blocks the synthesis of the estrogen and they are mainly inhibit the conversion from an androgenic precursor, which is the primary source of the estrogen in the postmenopausal women. What are the choices? The choices are the third generation aromatase inhibitors, that is anastrozole, letrozole and exemestane. These three drugs are more commonly used. They have more effect and they are more potent than the prototype of the aromatase enzyme inhibitors like aminoglutathione. If the comparison was made in the clinical trial, it has been found that the effects produced by the tamoxifen and the effects produced by the aromatic inhibitors are somewhat same. However, with the lower incidence of the thromboembolic events and the vaginal bleeding, which are very obvious from the use of the tamoxifen. Tamoxifen का जो side effect है जिसमें thromboembolic events होते हैं वो aromatase enzyme inhibitors के केस में नहीं होते. Another choice is the tamoxifen, which is a selective estrogen receptor modulator, which we already covered in a previous lecture. It is preferred initial agent when metastasis is present in a premenopausal woman. अगर प्री मेनोपॉजल वुमेन है तो टमोक्सिफेन देंगे. इफ इट इज अ पोस्ट मेनोपॉजल वुमेन देन वी विल यूज एनेस्ट्राजोल व्हिच इज द एरोमेटेज एंजाइम इनहिबिटर. अनदर प्रॉब्लम रिलेटेड टू द टमोक्सिफेन अलोंग विद द अदर साइड इफेक्ट्स व्हिच वी हैव डिस्कस्ड इन द प्रीवियस लेक्चर दैट इज द स्ट्रोक एंजाइना ड्यू टू द थ्रोम्बोएम्बोलिक इवेंट्स. देयर इज अ हाइपरकैल्सीमिया ड्यू टू अननोन रीजन. The reason is not established. However, it may suppose that it may be due to the transient stimulation of the hormone receptor tumors of the bone, like that are responsible for causing the bone resorption. Bone resorption ho raha hai shayad, due to which there is hypercalcemia after the use of the tamoxifen. Chlorimethylene is structurally similar to the tamoxifen with the difference only a single chlorine atom. However, the major difference between the two compounds is in the preclinical activity. Tamoxifen in a rat model, it has been found as a hepatocarcinogenic. Why? Chlorimethylene is not the hepatocarcinogenic. It means that for the secondary cancers like ovarian cancer, the chances are less in case of the chlorimethylene. Fulvestrant is a second line intramuscular agent that have a similar efficacy and safety as compared to the anastrozole or exemestane. However, it is an estrogen receptor antagonist with no agonist activity. It works both by down regulating and by the degrading the estrogen receptors. After the use of the endocrine therapy in the management of the metastatic breast cancer, a condition is reached where surgical or chemical ovarian ablation can be possible, but that lead to the sedation of the overall cancer growth rate, and it produces a similar effect. Overall response rate is similar with respect to the tamoxifen use. If we surgically or chemically ablate the ovary, the treatment protocol will be the same as the source of the estrogen will be cut off. How chemical ablation of the ovary is possible? It can be used by the radical castration with the luteinizing hormone releasing hormone analog voserelin, leuprolide or triptorelin. Voserelin, leuprolide or triptorelin, that is a reversible alternative to the surgery. If it is used as first line of therapy, then a combination with the tamoxifen will be there. The third line option is the progestin. It means ki progestin jo hai wo bahut far away aate hain. First choice hamare paas jo hai wo aromatase enzyme inhibitor hai, then tamoxifen hai, then we have the chemical ablation hai with the LHRH agonist or analog, then we have the progestins that are generally reserved for the third line therapy. The adverse effects are weight gain, fluid retention and thromboembolic events. The next table showing the summary of the endocrine therapy. First choice is the aromatase inhibitors, which are non-steroidal, anastrozole and letrozole. Brands are Arimidex, Femira. Anastrozole giving 1 mg orally daily, while letrozole is 25 mg orally daily. In some population, aromatase inhibitors will lead to the severe liver impairment. So, hepatic monitoring is essential after the use of the aromatase inhibitors. Exemestane, what is the difference between the other type of the aromatase enzyme inhibitor is that the exemestane is the steroidal aromatase inhibitor. It will take after the meal. The dose is 25 mg orally daily. If we talk about the SERMs, that is tamoxifen or chlorimethylene, the doses will be 20 mg or 60 mg. एंड फर्दर मोर वन मोर इम्पोर्टेंट थिंग इज दैट दे आर अंडर दर मेटाबोलाइज बाई दी साइटोक्रोम टू डी सिक्स सो द सेवरल ड्रग इंटरक्शन आर पॉसिबल आफ्टर द यूज ऑफ द टैमोक्सिफेन यू हैव टू इंक्लूड इन द प्राइम मोड देन वी हैव द एंटी एस्ट्रोजेंस दैट इज द थर्ड फुलविस्टाडिन एंड इट ऑल्सो हैज अ मॉडरेट लीवर इम्पेयरमेंट इट इज बेसिकली मेंट फॉर द आईएम रूट ड्रग विच इज अवेलेबल फॉर द एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन ऑफ द इंट्रामस्कुलर रूट द लोडिंग डोज इज 500 mg एंड आफ्टर दैट द डोज विल बी गिवन एट day 1 day 15 एंड day 29 मॉडरेट लीवर इम्पेयरमेंट कैन बी अकर आफ्टर द यूज ऑफ द फुलवास्टेरिन देन वी हैव द LH RH एगोनिस्ट लाइक Gocivaline, Leuprolide, Triborelin, that is, they are for the premenopausal women only. They are available for the subcutaneous and intramuscular injections. However, they are not approved for the from the FDA for the use of the breast cancer. If we talk about the progestins, which is the third choice, the initial doses will be the 40 mg orally 4 times a day. Due to the multiple dosage per day will also decrease the patient compliance. Another important thing is to remember that their absorption may be increased when they are taken with the food. So they are taken with the food. If we talk about the medroxyprogesterone, the dose should be decreased in case of the liver impairment. Other endocrine therapy include the androgens like floxacetine and it is 10 mg orally twice a day. Again, it is avoided in the severe renal or liver failure. Another important thing is that you will see in the treatment of the metastatic breast cancer the use of the estrogens. Usually, estrogen stimulates the progression of the especially estrogen receptor positive breast cancer. However, paradoxically, high dose of the estrogen suppresses the growth of these tumors in certain circumstances, and several types of prospective studies were carried out which showing that estradiol treatment, especially after the use of the aromatic enzyme inhibitors, regress the tumor. The use of the ethinyl estradiol is basically beneficial for those postmenopausal patients that are initially heavily treated with the aromatase enzyme inhibitors, which is followed by the use of the ethinyl estradiol. The use is avoided in the jaundice or in the mild liver diseases. See the use of the conjugated estrogens. This is all about the endocrine therapy for the management of the metastatic breast cancer. Now the chemotherapy. The chemotherapy, the choice of treatment is basically depends upon the patient characteristic and what are the expected toxicities that a person being exposed to the previous therapy. Single agents are usually associated with the lower response rate than the combination therapy, but time to progression and overall survival are more or less similar. So single agents are better tolerated and they are important consideration in the palliative metastatic settings. Table 60.3 is showing the strategy of the chemotherapeutic regimens. Remember that chemotherapy is basically reserved for those women that are hormone negative tumors, and these hormone receptor negative tumors are rapidly progressive or symptomatic. There may be a secondary tumors like lung cancer, liver cancer, or bone marrow involvement, and they are irresponsive of the endocrine therapy. Endocrine therapy se manage nahi ho rahe, then we will go for the chemotherapy. These are the hormone receptor negative tumors. Clinical trial and shows that combination regimens about producing the 60% response in a patient that are unexposed to the chemotherapy, while complete response occur in about 10% of the patient. And the median duration of the response is about 5 to 12 months, while median survival is about 14 to 33 months. Specific regimen selection is very difficult, and it is basically the choice of the physician or the expert who is deciding कि कौन सा रेजिमेन होना चाहिए. हाउएवर सिंगल एजेंट इज प्रेफर्ड ओवर द कॉम्बिनेशन अनलेस एंड अंटिल द पेशेंट हैज अ रैपिड प्रोग्रेसिव डिजीज, लाइफ थ्रेटनिंग डिजीज, और देयर इज अ नीड ऑफ रैपिड सिस्टमैटिक कंट्रोल. इनिशियल ड्रग ऑफ चॉइस, द मेन ड्रग दैट इज कंट्रोलिंग द कैंसर ऑफ द ब्रेस्ट, इन अगेन द एंथ्रासाइक्लिन्स एंड द टैग्लेन कॉम्बिनेशन अलॉन्ग विद द अदर टाइप्स ऑफ द कीमोथेरेपेटिक एजेंट्स. सिंगल एजेंट लाइक कैपिसाइटाबीन, विनोएलबिन एंड जेमसाइटाबीन ऑल्सो यूजफुल एंड दे हैव अ रेस्पॉन्स रेट ऑफ अबाउट 20-25% वेन दे आर यूज इन कॉम्बिनेशन विद द एंथ्रासाइक्लिन एंड टैग्लेन. Another new agent which is a microtubule stabilizing agent is the exabepine. Just like vinorelbine is indicated as either the monotherapy or in combination with the capecitabine in analog of the 5-fluorouracil. Another newer agent which is the ribavirin, which is a second anti-microtubule agent approved as a monotherapy for the metastatic breast cancer. And it is mainly reserved for those patients who have at least received 2 prior chemotherapeutic regimens for MBC. 2 regimens try ho chuke hain, control nahi hua, to phir second choice hamare paas ribavirin ki hai as a monotherapy. This is the table 60.3 which showing the different types of selected chemotherapeutic regimens meant for the metastatic breast cancer. The first choice is paclitaxel. As a single agent, that is 175 mg per meter square, CIV over 3 hours, that repeat cycles every 21 days. As we have discussed that in case of metastatic breast cancer, we are going for a normal sustainable dose. बहुत high doses हम नहीं देंगे. Paclitaxel 80 mg भी दे सकते हैं per meter square per week. हर week एक एक दे सकते हैं 80 mg में, या फिर 21 days के बाद 175 mg हम थोड़ी सी high dose करके दें. That repeat after 21 days, या 80 mg that repeat after 7 days. Then we have docetaxel 60-100 mg IV over 1 hour, that cycle either repeat 21 days. This is the higher dose. If the dose is reduced 30-35 mg, the cycle will repeat at each week and it is administered IV for 30 minutes. ये 30-35 mg हम 7 दिनों के बाद दे रहे हैं दोबारा. दोनों में सेम है, ड्रग सेम है, डोजेज चेंज है. Then we have the vinorelbine. The dose is 30 mg per meter square IV day 1 and day 8 and the cycle is repeated every 21 days. Or if the dose is changed or reduced to 25 mg, then it is given per week and the cycle repeat every 7 days depending upon the regression of the tumor. Then we have the gemcitabine, which is 600-1000 unit mg per meter square per week IV day 1, day 8 and day 15 we be weekly de rahe and the cycle is repeat after 28 days. Yani 15 days ke baad 28 days tak hum break lenge. There is need to hold a day 15 day dose based on the blood counts. Blood counts ko check karenge, iske baad hum dekhenge ki kitna, agar bahut zyada dangerous pancytopenia hua hai then pehle hum uski blood chemistry ko dekhenge, iske baad hum uska treatment continue karenge. Then we have the irubilin. Ribulin is 1.4 mg per meter square per dose IV that is infused about 2 to 5 minutes on day 1 and day 8. The dose is repeated 21 days. We have protein bound paclitaxel as well, that is given in the dose of 260 mg per meter square IV 30 minutes that repeat after 21 days. What is protein bound paclitaxel? It is differ from the paclitaxel by the addition of a larger protein, that is the albumin, which changes its distribution, that it moves from cell to cell. And paclitaxel protein bound is more beneficial, more superior as compared to the simple paclitaxel, and it also reduces its toxic effects. Normal paclitaxel is basically present in a solvent based formulation, which is a mixture of polyoxyethylated castor oil. However, in case of the NAB paclitaxel, which is a protein bound paclitaxel, is albumin bound nanoparticle formulation. This prevents the reaction associated with the preservatives that is present in a regular paclitaxel, and it also allows the higher doses that easily given by the use of the protein bound paclitaxel इन दिस यू कैन सी दैट 260 mg/m² कैन बी इज अ हायर डोज दैट गिवन फॉर 30 मिनट्स ऑफ टाइम देन द साइकिल विल रिपीट जस्ट 21 डेज. इंटरमीडिएट डोजेस इज स्किप. अगर हम डोज बढ़ा रहे थे तो आप देख सकते हैं तो हमें डेज कम करने पड़ रहे थे. दो तक हमें ज्यादा चाहिए तो देन वी विल गो फॉर दी प्रोटीन बाउंड पैकेटेक्सिल. देन वी हैव दी कैपासाइटाबीन इन 2000 to 2500 mg/m² per day orally divided twice daily for 14 days continuous देंगे. And the cycle is repeated after 21 days. 7 days का break है इसमें और उसके बाद हम continue करेंगे. These are the regimens. These are the drugs which are given as a monotherapy. However, these chemotherapeutic agents can be combined to form a regimen specifically for the metastatic breast cancer. Which are these? These are the combination of the docetaxel with capecitabine, in which docetaxel is 75 mg IV over 1 hour per day. While capecitabine is 2000 to 2500 mg/m² per day orally divided twice daily for 14 days. Or we have a combination of the exabipilone and the capecitabine. Or we have the combination of paclitaxel with gemcitabine and paclitaxel with the bevacizumab. After the use of the chemotherapeutic regimens, treatment is supported by the other biological or targeted therapy. What are these therapies? The examples of these agents are the three HER2 agents that are available as the trastuzumab, lapatinib and pertuzumab. Trastuzumab, lapatinib and pertuzumab are the newer targeted agents that are meant for the metastatic breast cancer. The major focus for the metastatic breast cancer is the use of the trastuzumab, and about 15 to 20% response rate is observed when trastuzumab is used as a single agent. Furthermore, this targeted agent can be a part of the regimen, and the regimen become a doublet or triplet. When it is a doublet, it is a combination of the taxane with trastuzumab and vinorelbine with trastuzumab. Or if it is a triplet, then the trastuzumab is given with the taxane and the platinum containing compounds. But the optimum regimen is not clear. It is written trial basis pe trial karte hain स्पेशलिस्ट के कौन सा रेजिमेंट जो है वो इफेक्टिव है. इट इज ऑल्सो डिपेंड अपॉन दी टॉलरेबिलिटी के पेशेंट कितना टॉलरेट कर सकता है साइड इफेक्ट्स को, और उस हिसाब से जो है वो ड्रग्स जो है वो कीमोथेरेपी रेजिमेंट्स जो है वो डिजाइन किए जाते हैं. सो ट्रास्टुजुमाब इज वेल टॉलरेटेड बट देयर इज अ रिस्क ऑफ द कार्डियक टॉक्सिसिटी इन अबाउट 5% ऑफ द पेशेंट इवन इफ इट इज अ सिंगल एजेंट. सो इफ इट इज कंबाइंड विद द एंथ्रासाइक्लिन द कार्डिक टॉक्सिसिटी विल बी हाई. सो इन सच सिचुएशन इट मे बी अवॉइडेड वेयर वी आर नॉट गोइंग फॉर द कार्डिक टॉक्सिसिटी. अनदर टारगेटेड थेरेपी इज द यूज ऑफ द लैपाटिनिब विच इज एन ओरल टायरोसिन काइनेज इनहिबिटर दैट टारगेट्स बोथ ऑफ द टारगेट्स दैट इज द HER2 एंड द एपिडर्मल ग्रोथ फैक्टर रिसेप्टर EGFR and HER2 को टारगेट करता है लैपाटिनिब विच इज एन ओरल टायरोसिन काइनेज इनहिबिटर. इट ऑल्सो इम्प्रूव द रेस्पॉन्स रेट एंड टाइम टू प्रोग्रेशन स्पेशली इफ इट इज गिवन इन कॉम्बिनेशन विद द कैपेसिटाबिन. स्पेशली वेन द कैपेसिटाबिन इज कम्पेयर्ड विद द कॉम्बिनेशन ग्रुप. अगर अलोन देंगे कैपेसिटाबिन तो रेस्पॉन्स रेट जो है वो इम्प्रूव नहीं है, बल्कि अगर उसमें लैपाटिनिब का एडिशन कर देंगे देन रेस्पॉन्स रेट विल बी इम्प्रूव स्पेशली इन दोज पेशेंट दैट आर प्रीवियसली ट्रीटेड विद द एंथ्रासाइक्लिन टैक्सेन एंड ट्रास्टुजुमाब. एंड द एडवर्स इफेक्ट ऑफ द लैपाटिनिब इज द रैश एंड डायरिया. एंड द ड्रग विच इज अ टारगेटेड ड्रग इज पर्टुजुमाब. पर्टुजुमाब इज अ मोनोक्लोनल एंटीबॉडी दैट बाइंड टू द डिफरेंट HER2 domain as compared with the trastuzumab, and it is also given along in the combination with trastuzumab प्लस अटैक्सिन विच इंक्रीजेज इट्स एक्टिविटी इन द कंट्रोलिंग ऑफ द मेटास्टेटिक ब्रेस्ट कैंसर. If I ask you that what is the use of the radiation therapy in metastatic breast cancer, so the answer of that basically radiation therapy is reserved to treat the painful metastasis or other localized sites of the disease, that is the brain and the spinal cord lesions, which are very painful, to decrease the metastasis of other localized tissues. Basically, radiation therapy is used. In 90% of the patient, the pain is relieved because of the reduction of the secondary tumors. At the end, we have to evaluate the therapeutic outcomes. As we all know that the goal of the for the early breast cancer is to treat. However, for the early breast cancer, it is mandatory to also manage the toxicities of the adjuvant chemotherapy. So, the function of the pharmacist is to monitor the drug-drug interaction and the toxicity of the regimens which the patient is using, and he or she counsel and advise the patient how to reduce the such toxicity. कैसे उन toxicity को reduce करेंगे? Approach for the locally advanced breast cancer, which is a type 3 cancer, it's that also including the inflammatory breast cancer as well. The target is again the cure, and it basically determined upon the time of the surgery and the desired end found at which the adjuvant chemotherapy can be started. So it properly evaluated to get the complete cure. In case of the metastatic breast cancer, the main outcome is to optimizing the quality of life instead of the cure. Rather than we want to improve the patient quality and decrease the symptoms by valid and reliable tools. For that purpose, the main approach in case of metastatic breast cancer is to start the least toxic therapy initially. सबसे पहले हम वो therapy start करेंगे जो सबसे कम toxic है. Then with increasingly aggressive therapy applied in a sequential manner that does not significantly compromise the quality of life. Furthermore, tumor response is measured by changing in the laboratory care test, diagnostic imaging or physical examination. Continuously जो है वो monitoring होगी. हर दफा 2-3 महीने के बाद certain test will be repeated and reassessed. What is the main condition of the patient? Correct current situation क्या है वो हर वक्त जो है वो assess होती रहेगी. Even if complete cure is possible और complete cure हो भी चुका है उसके बाद भी जो है वो continuously monitoring होती रहेगी ताकि रिकरेंस ना हो डिजीज का. ठीक है, दिस इज ऑल अबाउट यू हैव टू गो फॉर दी प्राइम. तमाम डोजेस आप नोट करें. डोजेस का आपने बीएसए से आपने कैलकुलेट भी करना है. बीएसए का फॉर्मूला मैं इसी में बता रही हूँ आपको. यू हैव टू टेक इन द हाइट ऑफ अ पर्सन इन सेंटीमीटर एंड यू हैव टू मल्टीप्लाई इट्स वेट इन केजी. यू हैव टू डिवाइड द प्रोडक्ट ऑफ हाइट एंड वेट बाय 3600 एंड टेक द स्क्वायर रूट ऑफ द आंसर. You will get the BSA of a person. You will find different types of formulas for the calculation of the BSA. However, Dubois formula is the most common one. You can also calculate the BSA by just using the internet BSA calculator, or you can download certain type of application that easily provided you the BSA of a person. For that you need is what you need is to determine the body weight. What is the body weight and what is the height of a person? That height should be converted into the centimeter, which initially we will measure in meter, then convert into the centimeter. After that we will keep this value or place this value in a formula to calculate. This is the example of a table. This is BSA calculate karte. For example, if the body weight is 78 and the height is 1.9 meter, the BSA will be 2.12, which is more. Agar hum dekhe normal agar weight dekhe to 51.3 and the height of the person is 1.58, the average is 1.5. If agar further agar hum reduce kare, for example 44 pe jaye, if the weight is 44, age is 40 and the height is 1.5, then there will be the change in the BSA is about 1.4. So depending upon the weight and age and the height of a person, BSA will be calculated, and all chemotherapy drugs are mainly given according to the body surface area. This is all about the breast cancer management. Thank you.